Sorry for the delay there, we're no talking or anything. Get this underway. It's just gonna be me commentating here. And more importantly, we have Law and Luck. This looks like a winner's. This could be like, yeah, a winner's round something match. Alright, we have Luck being one of our best players in Philadelphia area right now, ranking at around 4th on the PR. And Law. He's getting Luck in a very unfortunate situation here with the edge guarding. Luigi very prone to edge guarding, could be very bad for him. Law is giving no room for him for Luck to just get back on stage. Luigi was such a great grab. Coming in. Alright, so Logan's doing work right now. At this point, Law's just kind of running away, playing bait. Going in. Good shield right there. Good reaction from Law, trying to bait that up smash. So far, Law's been doing a really good job of just pressuring Luck right here, without even using tools like needles or anything to keep Luigi away. Of course, Luck has all this rage building up right now. All it takes is one up smash to just turn the tables. And a misfire! Now, I don't know if he would've been dead right there. Probably not, because he had the jump still. But that was still close either way. However, Law is taking the lead. Now this could be huge right here. If Law can just play the Sheik game, gain a lot of percent, you know, probably even needle camp a little bit, and just stay away from that ledge, then he could retain the lead against Luck. Luck is that quick, or else all that rage could just be bad for combos. Now, I'm not sure if. All right, that was good up air right there. Swing it out. Alright, tries to go for the long Luigi combos, only gets a down air out of it, but that's still good percent. Law shielding and grabbing. It's been a close game this entire time. And Law right now, going in off stage. Perhaps? No, he's just gonna let him wait. Mari here in the match has been very hasty just to go in and not try to get options out of Luck. But Luck isn't playing very patient all throughout. That's just how he is as a player. But he'll play very weird and wonky, and he can change up his play style in a second. So he could be playing very patient at first, and then all of a sudden, he just go in. I don't know if I like that option from Law right there. That was very strange, going for the double up B. That 50-50 turned into like a 15-70-85. Oh, Luck gets the misfire. Narrowly makes it back on stage. Living up at 135%. This could be bad for Luck. Sheik is in a very good position right here at 66%. Having Luck off stage, this is where Luigi does probably the worst in the game right here. If Luck can just get his bearings, get back on stage. Maybe get one potential grab combo, or just a jab up Shoryuken. That could change the whole tie and potentially win the game. But he's gonna be very careful off stage with a fair. We'll close out the game one. Game one, going to Luck. Oh, excuse me, going to Law. That's game one. All right. Luck, not very known for counterpicking too much. He has a couple characters like Olimar and a potential Sheik, that although he never pulls it out in tournament. It's more of just a running joke at this point. And he does make the switch to Olimar. Was not expecting that. He rarely ever pulls it out unless for campy matchups, so maybe he finds that this one is just a little bit too much for him as Luigi. We saw a lot of edge guarding from game one. Primarily, most of the game was just fought off stage. This way, you can actually just continue to rack up some percent. And even stack on Pikmin to avoid things like Bouncing Fish. Or at least delay it. Now, Olimar is one of these characters where we really don't worry about the lineup right here. Pay attention to those Pikmin. Because right in here, actually, this percent, this isn't really the best lineup. Because right here, most of those Pikmin are for killing. But he wants to hold on to that purple one, because that one is probably one of the best out of all of them. Throw the purple one with a mix of a couple other ones. And then all of a sudden, it's just very hard to get in on Olimar. Oh. Goes straight for the up air after the F-tilt. F-tilt being one of Sheik's best confirms. Alright, Luck jumps away from that Bouncing Fish. Very smart of his on his part. Comes back on stage. Gets him with a blue Pikmin on a grab. That could be bad, but he well manages to get out of it. Luck really needs a different set of Pikmin right here. If he can just get back on stage. Get a little breathing room. Alright, now he has a good lineup. Up throw. Actually killing. That was very good. Alright. We can see the laws really wanting to get something. Just some kind of conversion off stage. Not let Luck back on. What Law really could be doing right here, I think, maybe, is perhaps he could be playing, because right now he seems to be playing very patient, especially on the ledge, until he gets up. Then he just goes for the Nair, tries to confirm something else. And for the most part, it does work out. However, he could mix it up a little bit. Ooh. Law still worried about the Pikmin being on him at this point. And Luck is standing at a tall 154. Alright, Luck gets off the conversion. And then... I'm gonna have Trevi joining me on- not Trevi. Mini Boss joining me on the mic here.
A little somewhere. That's alright.
Getting rid of some of the solo commentary. Get that out of here. Alright, we're looking at a match on Law. Versus Luck.
Law versus Luck. Okay, yep. And Luck opting for Olimar. This is interesting.
We play out Luigi game one. Wait for the good one for the switch. After losing game one.
Oh, okay. I see.
So far, mostly game one. Luck was just getting an unfortunate positioning of just getting edge guarded and just playing most of the match off stage as Luigi, which is probably one of the one of the most unfavorable positions for that character.
That's true, yeah. His main power is just grabbing and all that, so if you force him off stage, he does have that. He is floaty, but he has a long time to recover too, so he does have a lot of edgeguard potential against him.
Right. I should say. Alright. Luck is a pretty alright setup for the Pikmin right now. He still has that blue waiting, so all it takes is the Law to be very careful with getting grabbed at this point.
Yeah, that's true, yeah.
And we could even see right there, Luck was actually getting up air. That's because he wanted to change the lineup of the Pikmin.
Good option. And the poison is actually a good option because I think it does a little bit more damage when it slaps like that.
Yeah. At this point, he might just want to throw out the... Yeah, he wants to get rid of that white Pikmin. Because right now he has a good lineup with the blue, purple, and red. They're all kill Pikmin, so...
Yeah, purple with aerials, blue with smashes. Just like that, and it did catch off on the right side. And that's where the blue went, so... Good recognition for Luck there. And I did like the switch too because he has better, I guess, projectile game because even the fireball is good, but it does straight away like two or three. But the Pikmin slap him so he can get a lot more while playing it safe with Olimar.
That's another thing too. A lot of these matchups we see with Luck, he actually just ends up getting camped out. And Olimar is his answer to that really. Because we could see that, Luigi, he gets a lot of pushback on his shield. He has a hard time struggling when people want to push him out.
Yeah, and Law seems to be switching in a lot more, going in a lot faster and a lot more close in. He's keeping the pressure on, so let's see how luck adapts to that this time around.
Olimar being one of those characters where unless you have the stock lead on him, he can basically time you out in all scenarios.
And again, just forcing Law off the side here. Ooh, push setups potential opportunity for...
That was a strange option, but I like it.
He might have thought he was recovering high instead of latching on. It's unpredictable.
The pushback from Law right there. He probably held down and didn't, or at least he intentionally did not catch the ledge because we can push him away.
Almost had the diamond cutter set up.
Oh, trying to go for the risky.
Ooh, that vanish coming through at the last second.
I like the way Law's getting back on stage in this game so far. He's avoiding a lot of Olimar's traps on the ledge. And he's just, and he's doing it in a way where he's just capitalizing on the way Luck is doing it. However, Luck is gaining percent fast right here.
Yeah, and on this last stock, you think he would be staying away a lot more, but he is just moving in with Olimar, getting the damage that he needs, already almost lapping him, just about 20 or so away. Exactly 20 away, actually.
Law's going to play a little bit less conservative at this point.
He's trying to get a bouncing fish edge guard set up, and a good forward air. Oh, force him to recover with
it.
A B, though. Oh, great vanish setup.
That vanish was very smart. Well-placed vanish right there. That ending that stock that he needed quick, or else his percent would just keep on building.
Yes, that was definitely key in order to at least have the potential to turn this thing around. He is hitting at 71, and he does have a purple, so the aerial game for Olimar is pretty strong right now.
And this is very good. This is good for Law right now, because now he can start setting up some combos where the conversions that he needs to start those combos won't end up in a kill for Luck.
And he does have a blue on deck as well, so those smash attacks are on deck as well. But he does expend the purple for a missed throw. He has to get back on main stage here in order to get more.
He's gotta be careful. All right.
And gets a purple back, okay.
We're seeing a white purple and
this
blue.
Is like the metagame inside the game. Figuring out what's good.
Could you imagine being the player against him? Like,
when you gotta keep track of all that? Yeah, that's nuts. That's insane.
So playing against Olimar players are just so you have to pay a lot more attention to little details like that.
Yeah, normally your eyes are on your opponent, but yeah, like Olimar has to keep one eye on himself sometimes too.
You gotta pay attention to your opponent. And three of our little guys.
Oh, and the fire coming through with that down smash yet again. And a reverse, too. Very nice.
Luck struggling at first to get in on Law, but finally cracking him down.
Cracking down on Law. Nice. I like that. That was a... I was surprised to... Yeah, good.
2-1 in Luck's favor. Go ahead.
Yeah, I was just surprised to see that he had that shift in playstyle, because, like, if you pick Olimar, normally you're going to stay away. But that last round, really,